Good morning. We're following breaking news out of Tampa this early morning.
Two Tampa police officers have been shot. We're just learning that one of them has died. Right now, there is a massive search for the suspects going on.
That shooting happened on 50th Street and 34th Avenue, just south of I-4. Now, Bill Logan is live at the scene. He joins us right now with the details. Bill, what can you tell us about what happened?
Boy, I tell you what, right now, Dia, this is a very fluid situation. There are dozens, if not hundreds, of officers out here. Is there any indication that they had that there was a problem with this car? What was the initial stop for?
I don't have the details on why the vehicle was initially pulled over. Traffic stops are one of the most dangerous things that police officers do. You never know who is in the car. You never know if that person is armed.
We have been told earlier in the morning that one police officer died. Another in critical condition.
Right over here, there's a car coming through, and you can see how the officers are going to slowly stop them, put the flashlight right up into the window.
A large section of East Tampa has been shut down right now. We want to get a bird's eye view from Captain Al to see just how big this perimeter is. Captain Al, what can you tell us?
Hey, let's take a look at North 50th Street, just north of I-4, about midway between Columbus Drive and 50th Street. That's where it all unfolded.
Just a few moments ago, all the Tampa police squad cars out here scrambled out of here, and now the only people monitoring this intersection are the deputies from HCSO.
The suspect spun around, pulled a firearm and shot both police officers. Officer Jeff Kocab died this morning. And Dave Curtis is on life support at this time.
Jeff, who has passed away, has a wife who is 9 months pregnant.
Past couple of minutes here at this staging area, we've seen a lot of SWAT officers arrive. We've seen them suit up and then take off.
From here, it looks like they're surrounding a used car lot, but what they're more concerned with is what's behind it, and that's an apartment complex. And I want you to take a look at some video we shot earlier. Again, as you said, these are the Bristol Bay Apartments. I want to stress this is not live video, but as you can see, it looks like there's a SWAT team there.
We understand the mayor has just announced that Officer Jeff Kocab's wife, who is 9 months pregnant, is having contractions and may have gone into labor.
Yeah, that's true. I just talked to the mayor moments ago and she did confirm that.
Good evening and thank you for joining us. I'm Jamison Euler.
And I'm Linda Hurtado. We begin with Chris Martinez, who has the very latest on the search for the suspect. Good evening, Chris.
Good evening to you, Linda. Tampa Police Chief Jane Castor tells me they are following up right now on a number of very strong leads.
Right now, investigators are questioning 22-year-old Courtney Nicole Brantley about the deadly shooting of two police officers. A massive manhunt began, and around 9 a.m., it centered around Tampa's Bristol Bay Apartments. But it took law enforcement from at least three different agencies surrounding the complex for more than 3 hours before a SWAT team was able to bring Brantley out.
There were law enforcement vehicles all up and down 50th Street here, US 41. But again, this is where most of the action was centered. It is an apartment complex under siege. This video, shot from a phone, captured the moments as law enforcement moved in to arrest Courtney Brantley.
And as soon as I got outside, there's SWAT teams everywhere.
We were here when the first bouquet of roses was actually laid down by a family. And now look at this behind us, just filled with daisies and roses and lilies, all laid by people with a heavy heart.
They had been trying for a long time to have a child, and it wasn't easy. And now it's sad that he won't be able to be there.
He had no idea just how long and how serious Morris's criminal history was.
It is 14 pages long, begins in 2002.
We watched tonight as dozens of officers and deputies, many undercover, were briefed on who they were looking for, and minutes later, they were sent out to catch an accused killer.
It was just after 2 in the morning when 17-year-old Keisha Cohen and her girlfriend Renee Trinette heard the tragedy begin to unfold just a few feet from their front door.
It was just like pow, pow. And then that's when the dude had started running and the girl had spun off and left.
But when we heard the gunshots, we jumped back in the door. We looked out the window. We seen a young man running. We seen the police car still there.
They said the cruiser was still running and officers David Curtis and Jeffrey Kocab were lying on the ground.
When I checked his pulse, he was still, I was like, he's breathing.
It almost seemed appropriate that as the order to present arms was given, the heavens opened up. But the rain couldn't hide the tears
as Tampa Bay said goodbye to two fallen heroes.
Jeff, young guy, go-getter. Just always moving, didn't want to stop. Hard worker, just a good guy. Dave, well, Dave and I,
Steve Roy worked on Squad 306 with officers Dave Curtis and Jeff Kocab. A double tragedy that required two riderless horses to lead the procession and two 21-gun salutes. Bagpipes played as an honor guard escorted the coffins to two waiting hearses. Doves flew overhead as police officers from around Florida and across the nation watched and listened to the final radio call.
All units be advised, Officer Jeffrey Allen Kocab, Badge 302, and Officer David Lamar Curtis, Badge 459, having bravely served their community with Tampa Police Department Squad 306, ended their watch on June 29th, 2010. I mean, God rest their souls.
The one thing I heard time and time again as Tampa Bay said goodbye to these two heroes is please don't forget their service and their sacrifice. In Lutz, Don Grimes, ABC Action News.
Side by side, they led the city of Tampa. Mayor Pam Iorio and Police Chief Jane Castor. They stood together as they tried to help citizens cope with the news. Two police officers, David Curtis and Jeffrey Kocab, were killed in the line of duty.
Our hearts are just breaking.
Then, for nearly 4 days, they stayed strong, reassuring citizens every available resource was dedicated to catching the killer. While both showed a brave front, both women shared with me, this was the toughest test they had to endure. For both the mayor and the chief, it started with a phone call.
Your first thought is it's not possible, and then as I prepared to go to the hospital, I just prayed the entire time that it was some kind of mistake was made and it just was not true.
I received a call at about 3 a.m. from Chief Castor, and I've received other calls, but they've not ever been quite as definitive. With this one, she started off by saying, Mayor, we've had a shooting. One officer is dead and the other is in critical condition. I went to the hospital and Jeffrey Kocab was already dead. Then I went to see Dave Curtis, and the doctors made it very clear that he was not going to live. Both had been shot in the head.
Chief Castor told me they then waited for the wives, Kelly Curtis, a mother of four boys, all under the age of 9, and Sarah Kocab, 9 months pregnant.
I mean, there's no words to describe that. But again, as painful as it was for me to deliver that news, I can only imagine receiving it.
But for these women, true grieving could not begin until the alleged killer was caught. A tougher task than both ever imagined. For the chief, it was her lowest point.
We were doing everything that we could to find him. And, you know, we had gone down so many promising roadways to find out that they were dead ends. And there was a point where it was very frustrating. You know, no one slept. And we've just done everything we can, and we just couldn't put our hands on him.
With each hour, their greatest fear grew.
We were very concerned that it would end in more violence. And so we just could not rest until he was captured. Could not rest, not for a moment.
So was there a huge fear that there would be a gun battle of sorts?
Yes, and that's something that Mayor Iorio and I talked about. You know, here's an individual who just got out of prison in April, who has a very violent past, and killed two police officers in cold blood. So my position is he's not afraid to use force. And I was very afraid. That's, you know, why you couldn't sleep at night. And we couldn't stop until we had him in custody, because we could not afford to have an innocent citizen or another police officer hurt.
The fear gripped them for nearly 4 days until Morris turned himself in. The timing was a huge relief. The funeral of these officers was just a few hours away. And as they were during this entire ordeal, both women walked side by side, helping guide thousands to a final farewell. It was also time for
for them to grieve.
These are things you just never, never forget. They really do change you because it's so searing.
Sometimes a little kindness can mean so much. A Tampa family knows this firsthand, and tonight they want you to know too.
The kids asked if they could draw a picture and get it to the family somehow, and I said, well, I don't know about that, but we could take it down to the memorial.
Nicholas Josh and Nicole Reynolds left drawings in crayon. It's the least they could do to say thank you.
And I noticed in the window, the headlight was out, and I was like, oh, great, this is not good. Not 5 minutes after I pulled out on the road, I see the lights flashing in the mirror, and I was thinking, oh, this is just my luck.
Dolly Reynolds hasn't had much luck lately. She was laid off from her job with 3 mouths to feed. She needed a break, and a Tampa police officer gave her one.
He was young. He looked young, and
he looked in the car, and he saw her sleeping, him with me, and he said, well, I'm not going to give you a ticket, but where do you live?
And she says the police officer escorted her home and waited outside until everyone got in safely.
When we turned on the news and they had the pictures up there, just the second I saw him, wow, I can't believe that's him.
His face is one she'd never forget.
He had his window down. I turned around and I waved and said thanks, and he smiled and just kind of went like that and drove off.
Her family wants you to know Officer Jeffrey Kocab's small act of kindness meant so much.
In a place where the silence of grazing cattle is broken by an occasional car, where Main Street is peppered with a farm supply store and a farmer's market, this is where Officer David Curtis and his wife chose to raise 4 young boys. This is Webster in Sumter County. It is a place where people come to the speckled butter bean as much for the food as to talk.
He was very friendly, outgoing, and he enjoyed his family and his life.
That is where I met Clay Walker, who knew and spoke to David Curtis just days before he was gunned down.
It's hard to really believe in somebody like that is just all of a sudden gone, and it's over nothing.
It is something that no one can understand. And because of that, in this small community, whether they knew David or not, their streets have now collided with the streets of Tampa, with one of their own taken much too soon. And it is that loss that David's church, St. Anne's Catholic Church in Dade City, is trying to help mend.
When a family's confronted by something this horrible, how do they find strength to move ahead? What can they do?
Well, a family has to reach out to each other, and family members support each other in cases like this, and that's the greatest strength there is.
The crew at Newman's Barbecue, one of 15 teams making nearly 3,000 slabs of ribs, didn't get much sleep the night before. Ricky Newman's a pro in the world of competitive barbecue cooking, but he's also a Polk County deputy who couldn't help but want to help the families of 2 fallen Tampa police officers he never knew.
There's nothing we could do could take away any of the pain for that, could bring these guys back. But this is just our way that we can help them out with the future.
Even before the event was supposed to start, the slabs of ribs started going. Orders of meat were packed into the kitchen, wrapped in foil, and quickly sent out. ABC Action News volunteers helped the long lines of customers getting not just ribs, also t-shirts and donated desserts. In another room, even more money poured in for the live auction. Only at one point in the day was there a very somber moment. A friend of both officers, Dave Curtis and Jeff Kocab, Officer Scott Rabin and his horse D'Artagnan, paid tribute to the 2 men and their families. And you could see how some were moved.
It'll tug on your strings. This affects you emotionally. It's nice. You try not to relive everything that we went through, but this will make your eyes get watery.
In the middle of this busy fundraiser, the 2 women who lost their husbands but gained the support of strangers, Mrs. Curtis with tears in her eyes, and Mrs. Kocab, who's a dean at this very school, smiled as people greeted her.
I don't get more than a step or two without someone stopping to talk to them and provide a word of support or encouragement.